Hey everyone, we at Midday.com are super excited to have Mahima Makwana, the beautiful actress of Antim. Do you want to tell us firstly, you know, how excited were you when you got this film?
Hi everyone. I didn't have the privilege, you know, to get this film. I auditioned for it. I was called for an audition by the production house, and I had none other than Mahesh sir auditioning for the film. So I was literally petrified at first that, you know, am I going to make it to this? And you know, there were a lot of apprehension that I had. But I think I gave the audition with earnestness and honesty. That's how I bagged the role.
And it's been an, you know, inspiring journey. Like, you started out from scratch and, you know, you've reached here. Mm-hmm. So do you want to tell us about your journey, especially since you have spoken about how you've been raised by a single parent and you had to make it on your own?
Yeah.
So please tell us about that.
So, you know, I started off when I was 9-10, and the intent was, my mother wanted to become an actor. It was her dream. Yeah. And somehow she saw the actor in me. So I think I owe my journey and my dream to her. And somehow I wanted to, you know, make her dream come true. And at the same time, you know, one of the responsibilities were to make sure that the house runs and, you know, the kitchen runs. And, you know, there were some decisions that I also had to make in order to balance it, to run the house as well as to make my profession my passion. And somehow, you know, when I started acting at the formative age, you know, formative years of my life, I realized that, you know, this is what I want to do for the rest of my life. And, you know, I enjoy being in front of the camera. You know, I was always a filmy bug.
Okay.
So, you know, that bug bugged me quite early in life. And I think that's how it began. I started off quite early. TV happened. I did a lot of television shows. Then I thought that, you know, maybe I should get out of my comfort zone and take up challenging projects, which is why you also see me taking up not so monotonous characters that I did. I tried to challenge myself with every choices that I made in television. Then I was like, you know, there has to be some risk taken. Then I tried my luck in OTT. I was fortunate enough to get a few web shows. Then happened South, and then this, I think Antim happened out of nowhere. So to take you through my journey, it has been an amalgamation of crest and troughs. It's I think I would call my journey a piece of peaks and valleys, because to born in a family where I have my where I just have a single parent, there were a lot of things that we had to face. I've started from scratch, and I think I own the fact that, you know, I've had such a difficult journey. But I think had it not been that case, I wouldn't have been the person. I wouldn't have valued things the way I do. And you know, that's how it started. But at the same time, I made sure that simultaneously I keep up with my education. I keep up with forming an identity and identifying myself. The kind of, you know, so it was I think I learned my job at my job. There was nothing extraordinary, workshops or nothing that I did. And I think no better than learning your job on the sets.
And so, like you said, you know, you had a long journey. You started out as a child. So anything that you learned on the job that helped you with this film as well?
I think everything that I learned, you know, I was just thinking that it's not a thing or two that I would want to add to this, but I think it's the whole experience that I had in TV. It made me more confident as an actor. You know, it made me more familiar with the camera, because I never realized that, you know, the kind of experiences that I've had in television. There were several television shows that I did, the other projects that I did. It kept adding up to my journey. And you know, you don't realize that, you know, the life experiences that you have, the professional experiences that you have, it changes you, you know, because change is the only constant, and it adds up to your experiences. And you know, because on Antim, to first of all, you know, to share screen space with Salman sir and, you know, Ayush and Mahir sir helming the project was quite challenging. You know, I don't know how did I manage pulling it off, but then I think I owe it to my television industry, and I'll be forever indebted for the experiences that I've had.
And handling fame at such a young age, so how did you kind of manage that, you know?
I am still the same person how I used to be back in the day. Okay. And just when I enter my house, I enter the doorstep, and there's nothing that has changed. You know, today also I've got the film. I'm so blessed that I have the people in my life that I have, that they keep me grounded, and there is no chance for me to let I hope, you know, this stays the same. I'm not taking anything for granted. And I think because of the journey that I've had, because of the experiences that I've had in my life, I don't think I will ever let anything get to my head, because there was always a conscious choice to not let the innocence go, to not let the vulnerability go, to not let the spark go. Because even though I've had the experience that I've had, I still look at it as a beginning. Because, you know, learning never stops, and there's a lot for me to learn. There's a lot for me to look forward to, and I'm sure that it's not going to be an easy job. It's not going to be an easy journey. I don't look at it as fame or success, and I also think that fame and success is quite peripheral. You know, it's how you look at it. You know, for me, success is when I see myself on the big screen, but it's quite subjective, and I think these things, they come, they go, and yeah.
And do you remember your first day on the sets? Like, were you,
excited, you know, I'm going to tell you, they called me on the first day and I had my first shot with none other than Mahesh sir. You know, he plays my father in the film, and he just told me that, Mahima, are you ready? I said, I hope yes. And we just gave it a shot. And that first day was like a dream. You know, I saw myself in the same in the same screen on the same page with sir, and it just felt out of the world. I was just overwhelmed with the fact that, you know, he believed in me, he saw the potential in me, and that means a lot. So I made sure that I keep giving my 110% to the job that I was offered.
And how is he as a director? Is he like scary to work with, or
I thought that he would be very scary and very intimidating, but to my surprise, he was absolutely contrasting to what I thought. He is a super fun, chill person to be around. You know, I have been a huge fan of the contribution that he has done to the cinemas, be it Vastav, be it Nat Samrat, be it Astitva, be it all the kind of content that he's offered. He is, I don't know how he somehow has the magic of writing stories which are a perfect blend of realism, layered characters, depth, as well as giving it a commercial touch. So I think he believed in me as an actor, and I think because of that, he just let me be. If he saw there's something going off, or, you know, he was always there to guide me. But there was a space of spontaneity and freedom that he gave us as actors. And also because he's also an actor himself, he didn't like his actors to restrict themselves with some sort of preparation. So he was like, come to the set prepared, but there would be some magical moments that we will create, and that won't be on paper. We'll do it on its own, because, you know, I think what you do on set and what's written in the script are absolutely two different things. I'm really fortunate that I get to start my Bollywood career with him, because his vision is, he's a man of, I think, few words, and his vision speaks for himself.
And of course, you have a huge body of work, but, you know, sharing screen space with someone like a Salman and even Ayush, so how was that really? How did you prepare yourself for that?
Impeccable. You know, more than sharing screen space, I was so intimidated by the fact that, you know, I will be literally on his set. So, you know, I don't think that I'll ever be able to describe that feeling, because first are always first, and they're going to be special. So I think what means a lot to me is that he believed in me. He saw Manda in me, you know, Salman sir. And, you know, you realize his fame and success is when you enter the same frame with him. He has had a journey of a magnum opus, and he's nothing but inspiring, you know. It was a dream come true, like I keep saying, and it really is. So it was a great experience to have, you know, shared screen space with Ayush as well, because he is absolutely a hardworking person. He's given this film everything that he had, and he's so inspiring, the kind of dedication that he had throughout the project. There were a few episodes where we were not shooting the film in the linear motion. You know, we had, you know, sometimes we would do a romantic sequence, sometimes we would do a market yard sequence. So, you know, we were never going linear in terms of the shooting process. And it becomes difficult because, you know, you have a diet that has to be maintained. You also have, you know, he was on a strict diet, and he would work out despite of his fingers getting fractured, despite of having a really exhausting day at shoot. He gave it all. So, you know, I think I'm really proud of him now that I know him, now that we have worked together. I really, you know, if there's one actor that we all should watch out for, then it's him, because I couldn't have imagined anybody else playing Rahulya the way he did. Because not just the physical transformation, he's you know, when you do something with earnestness and honesty, it shows, you know. But he was I didn't expect him to, you know, surprise me in the emotional scenes and, you know, the layered scenes that we had.
And also, you know, when you have such a huge star cast, so usually people assume that the attention will be on the men. So how do you kind of hold your own, you know? And
I think the way the character was written did the job for me. Okay. You know, I feel even though we have a perception, or maybe it's a preconceived notion, that an actor's barometer is judged on the basis of the screen time that they have. But I don't think that's the case anymore. Even though we have Salman sir on the forefront, Ayush on the forefront, we know that there's this girl who has a voice. And for me, she was absolutely inspiring and liberating. You know, she, within the limited screen space, you see her having an arc, you see her vulnerable space, you see her taking a stand for herself. So I think the characteristics itself were so strong enough that I didn't have to worry about. And also, it's a dream opportunity, it's a dream debut. So I'm not sure about my attention going, whether I'll be able to outshine or whether I should, you know, do something. I just performed and gave it my best shot. That's all that I have to say about this.
So it was lovely talking to you, and thank you, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you.
Subscribe to Midday India. Get direct notifications on all our videos by clicking on the bell icon.